Welcome everyone to a Baseball America video. I'm John Manuel, editor of Baseball America magazine. We're in the Nike Fieldhouse here in beautiful downtown Omaha, Nebraska. A new Nike Fieldhouse right down the street, down Mike Fahey Street, from the new TD Ameritrade Park, Omaha, the new home of the College Series. And with me is someone who is no stranger to College Series, George Horton, head coach at Oregon. Fourth year as the head coach at Oregon, three seasons with a team. Start the program from scratch there, Coach Horton. Thanks for joining us, obviously. Just always excited to see you in Omaha. I mean, it's always a pleasure to see you. But I mean, Omaha's, I guess the one painful part, I guess, is that we've got to be here with a team and be here to talk to you.
Yeah, thanks, John. Pleasure to be here. And as I've often said, the best place for George Horton and my family to be on the face of the earth in the month of June is Omaha. Unfortunately, it's bittersweet each and every year. I have committee work here. Certainly get this opportunity to see the first two games of Ameritrade, what a tremendous facility that is. And it always makes me sad when I sit there and stand and watch somebody else play when we're not participating. It's certainly a good goal to work for.
I just can't imagine what that's like as a coach when this is the goal. And I guess a part of that is what makes Omaha so special is that, you know, we're based in Durham, North Carolina, and down the street, I live in Cary, and that's where the Division II World Series is now. And it's been there for 3 years, and it's a great facility. I don't think Division II players or any other sport, really, they come up the Final Four for the BCS Championship game. Those venues change. That seems like that's what makes Omaha special, is that word just means so much in college baseball.
Yeah, and you start with the community and the people and the fans, and now with all the tournaments and youth tournaments that are going on.
Right.
The environment has grown and how the city has embraced the athletes, the coaches, the media, your organization, obviously, the vendors. It's been a switch from Rosenblatt to downtown, but I think the true sense of, at least the way George Horton sees it, many of the coaches have been fortunate enough to be here, we're going to miss the iconic Rosenblatt Stadium. People have an adrenaline rush when your heart's pumping out of your chest. But what really makes it special is the word Omaha, the community here, and how they've embraced the athletes and coaches over the years, and really makes you feel like a big leader for a short period of time. It's quite a few.
Talk a little bit about some of the challenges when you're starting a program. I mean, I think Oregon nationally is associated a lot with Nike, obviously, the headquarters, the football uniforms. How many looks did you guys have? Didn't you guys have a press conference rolled out, eight different uniforms?
Six and growing.
Yeah. Okay, six and growing. I mean, which one is this a standard one right here? This is the system of dress, the Nike system of dress. And this just seems like almost like too staid, not neat enough to be Oregon almost.
Yeah, it's a little combination, and I will tell you, it's a great thing to be associated with Nike, and of course Bill Knight and his influence on our university and our athletic department.
Sure.
And we were partners with Nike when I was at Cal State Fullerton.
Okay.
It's just gone up tenfold because now being at the University of Oregon and our location and the Beaver tenant, I often tell the story when I was with Nike at Cal State Fullerton, I would meet with Al Melhorn sitting one-on-one when I got the job at the University of Oregon. I had a meeting with Todd Van Horn and about six design people and boards of not only aesthetic uniforms, but their modern technology, the advantage of the hypercool uniform, which is what we're looking at right now, that it's vended in different areas, that their performance based not only attractive and on the outside edge of extreme in some cases, like a football uniform
right.
For the national championship, but functionally, if you took that uniform off of the statue, it would weigh about a third of the weight of the Cal State Fullerton uniform that we used to wear. So not only is it attractive, it's great for recruiting because it draws that kind of marketing.
Sure.
The youngster that likes that look, George Horton likes that look. It's on the outer edge of modernized, but performance-wise, which is probably a coach's highest priority,
right.
It gives you every advantage that you possibly can to compete at the highest level.